Phillips. I'm an advisor at the High School for Recording Arts. I'm a Renaissance man. I do everything within the arts, and art is my life.
So people, we are at Urban Lights. This is a classic historical record store in St. Paul, Minnesota. All right? Check it out. Look at all the people who's up there. Look at all the posters. You can feel the history in here, y'all. So it's a pleasure and it's an honor to sell this CD at Urban Lights. Yes, indeed.
Yes, I teach a class called Hip Hop History and the Arts. I founded it almost 3 years ago, and it's been an excellent journey. And the latest place in my journey that I'm at is at the High School for Recording Arts.
All right, right now we at Fifth Element right now, one of the dopest record stores and clothing stores in South Minneapolis, like in the whole city. But we're gonna go talk to the people right now.
The next move is the album that we started working on the second semester of last school year. In the Hip Hop History and the Arts class, I gathered the students around and I said, we're gonna make the best album that we could possibly make that speaks about your generation, that speaks about your feelings, your emotions, as far as what you've been going through, what you are going through, and when you're headed in life. And so we just come up with different topics as far as from overcoming stress to love. We have a song called Essence of a Woman where it's an all-female MC song with a female singer, just to speak from the perspective of a woman and her knowing her essence and her self-respect as a woman. So we touch base on a lot of different aspects of art and life, and then we open up the curtain. The Next Move album was done.
The Next Move, it just came out. That's what we are about.
The next move means that you're contemplating on what your next move in life is. You're thinking about all the different things that motivate you, that inspire you, and you are completely focused on getting to that next step of your life. So the next move is relevant to what anybody is thinking as far as where they're going next. But you have to be focused in order to be in the mind state of, okay, this is my next move, let's go. That's what the next move is.
I go by Jay Suave. You know what I'm saying? 20-year-old recording entrepreneur, quote unquote. You know, that's who I am. I am what I am. Now, my role out this process was, you know, just that unique flow. You know what I'm saying? That extra spice to the gumbo. You know what I'm talking about? And yeah, you know, I was just that missing piece to the puzzle. Probably. I don't know. That's probably it, you know. That's what I was thinking. Yeah. I'm on track number 5. It's called Not Me, and pretty much it was just me explaining me being that unique spice to the gumbo and stuff. And yeah, you know, I heard the beat. My brother Jayvon Shaw, Hazy Burns, made it. And yeah, I was just vibing to it, you know. I just put an emotion of me, like, kind of like just identifying myself, you know what I'm saying, as a different individual from everybody else. So the way I was rapping was, you know, kind of like explaining who Suave really is, because I was just forming it to myself. So, you know, I'm sitting on the couch cooling it, you know what I'm saying? Like, I bought this mug, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just comfortable with everything I do, you know? If you ain't comfortable, it ain't gonna come out right. It's just like being in a room with people you never met, you know what I'm saying? If you ain't feeling the vibe, you ain't feeling the vibe, so. Well, yeah, I look at HSRA as family, you know what I'm saying? We bump heads like family, you know, we do everything, you know, so Yeah, this school is most definitely different than any other school I've been to, you know, because I went from public schools to charter schools, you know what I'm saying? I was thinking it was going to be something different, but yeah, man, HSRA is the place to be, you know. Man, Jay Suave next move is to be famous, you know what I'm saying? I want all y'all to Google Jay Suave, you know what I'm saying? I make music outside of school music, so if y'all want to hear from me, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna be somewhere. I'm just gonna keep inclining instead of declining. You know what I'm saying? I'm just trying to go to the top.
We're releasing an album called The Next Move.
Honesty, and they're gonna tell you a little more about the process of the class and everything, what they've learned. Go ahead, talk to them.
Well, we learned promotion, how to promote, you know, the album and ourselves, basically, you know, Honesty, anything.
And we learned how to build the fan page and all that. Here goes a copy of it right here. The next move.
Oh, and we also learned how to incorporate the audio into it and, you know, sharing links and stuff and make sure we get money for that stuff, not just giving out free music because, you know, you always want to get paid for your words.
The mini apple, ain't no better feeling than when the whole city backs you. This is Prince's Land, Terry Lewis, Jimmy Jam. And nowadays, it's skinny in the city, man. Rep the town. Hey, check the style. Hey, the flat top gold chain like the 80s, man. Hate me now. Hey, take a bow. Hey, his royalty, tilt the crown, kiss the ring, my man, and show your love. But skinny in the city. I don't talk, I prove. And if you chill, if you real, if you will, you can get with this committee. Tell them who you are, my dude. The young kid from Minnesota, where winter's never over. The Vikings and the Wolves, the Twins and the Gophers. An independent soldier, that's how I flip my dough up. Lindell, Nicolet, and the pen, my man. Young kid from Minnesota, I sit up on that corner while I sit and drink a...
So right now we're inside of Fifth Element. This is a historic record store in the Twin Cities. Founded by the Rhyme Slayer. Shout out to Kevin Beecham. Shout out to Brother Ali. Shout out to Toki Wright. Shout out to Ourself Divine. The whole crew. We're talking. So, here we are. Gonna be releasing it here. Giving up some copies. Y'all definitely come through. Next move. All right.
Scott? Yeah, my name is Scott Harrell. Everybody knows me. I'm the CEO of music nonprofit Rock the Cause. We're also a record label. In this class, we're gonna teach you how to digitally release an album in a digital age of music, because we all know the CD's going away, everything's being done digitally right now, press kits, Twitter, Facebook, etc. How do you work with the national press? How do you work with radio stations? How do you work with the bloggers? Everything that you need to do to release a successful album digitally, and we're gonna be releasing this album in tandem with Rock the Cause Records through our music distributor, The Orchard, which is the largest digital music distributor in the world.
You know, Rock the Cause was started out of a need to get young people involved in their communities, and it really started at a charter school called Watershed High School several years ago, where my daughter came to me and said, my school is going under, there's not enough funding, and you know musicians, you know bands, can you help put a concert together for my school? So I assisted the students at Watershed High School to build a fundraiser for their school. And they needed about $100,000. Now, they didn't get that $100,000 raised. They actually ended up raising about $5,000. But the story about what the students did to try to make their school better and to save it from financial disarray made the front pages of the Minneapolis Star Tribune, got to NPR's Morning Edition, and also made it to the head of the Department of Education for the state of Minnesota, who stepped in and really got the school back on track.
At 3:30 p.m., I have a conference call with the Chief Operating Officer of The Orchard, Ken Abdo, who is one of the most powerful entertainment attorneys in the world. I mean, he does everything from Kanye West to Jay-Z to Daryl Hall and John Oates. The man's a heavy. Laura Sobiak was Zach Sobiak's mom. Ann Brown was Sammy Brown's mom, which is Zach Sobiak's bandmate. Ariana, Amanda Sirianni, who is the former senior vice president of artist development and marketing for Downtown Records. They're going to be on that call at 3:30. We're going to be talking about the Orchard hiring a publicity and a marketing team and a radio promotion company for Europe, for Rock the Cause, for the Zach Sobiak releases, but also possibly some other stuff that Rock the Cause is doing in the future as well. So I'm going to bring it up on that phone call, and it's going to be talking on speakerphone, and I'll pull it in and out of mute as I'm talking. But if everybody's chill for about a half hour, you can get a window into this world and hear how this whole thing goes down. Then we're going to work on the press release for your album.
You know, Chadwick has been gracious enough to invite me in just to really focus on teaching students the things that we just talked about. How to use social media, how to use Twitter, how to use Facebook, how do you write a press release, what is a music license, how do you license music, what are all the different avenues that you have to build your voice and your presence out there to a greater community, not just locally, but to a greater community so people hear and discover your music and quite possibly want to buy it so you have a living as an artist. Very important. The artist deserves to make a living. And so we're teaching students here how to have life skills and job skills so that when they walk out this door, what I've seen with this school is many students think they have three options. I'm either going to be an athlete, I'm going to be a hip-hop artist, or I'm going to be other.
What does the next move mean to you?
I think the next move means something like just elevating and enhancing whatever your situation is, just taking it to the next level, taking another step forward, you know?
Right.
Just moving forward. The next move is something that should be big and massive than the move that you took before you got to that move.
We're going to keep moving this in the next move album. I mean, there's all sorts of stuff we're going to be doing, like there's going to be a concert coming up this fall that, you know, other people will hear about, but it's mainly continuing to work with the students to push this album, to quarterback this album, to get it in front of as many people as we possibly can.
Your next move better be your best move, better yet a chess move. I think like I'm old school, trying to get my future tight. My present ain't looking right, think I need to change it up, maybe try a different time, maybe get another job, a 9-to-5. Work until my hands get tired. Think I need less attitude. Maybe be a different dude. Passing normal attitude whenever that I'm passing through. I'm trying to be a pacifist. I don't want to blast the clip, cause I got so much knowledge that they call me activist. Or just call me prodigy. Yada D's is probably contemplating master plans. I'm trying to buy Monopoly. They stopping me? Nah, I'm working so hard. Life is like a game.
So, what has been some of the things you've learned in this class?
Well, a lot of the things they've been teaching us is how to make an electronic press kit to kind of put your music out there, send it to different, I don't know, radio stations, just stuff like that. But we're actually about to get interviewed by KDWB. It's gonna be really cool.
Really?
Yeah, it's gonna happen tomorrow.
Really, it's cool. Well, how far do you plan to go with the whole music thing?
I'm trying to go to the top. As far as possible.
As far as possible, man. Does it scare you?
Not really. I mean, I'm more intrigued by the whole...
the whole thing. Like
the whole entire thing.
The whole big thing. Has this class been helpful?
Probably one of the most helpful classes. I mean, it's really showed us how to get on your work and...
Really? Yeah. Really? Well, on what different levels of helpfulness has this class been, you know? Like, on a level, like, I could probably go, you know, to the local spots, you know, or on a level as I could probably be in California in the next couple of years. Like, how helpful?
Probably California in the next couple of years, just because really? They're so connected with all of these, like, really big companies, and it's just super cool.
Really? Well, what was the greatest moment?
I'm not even sure.
All of it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. Well, thank you, Sean, you know. It's good, man.
Thanks, man.
Good, man.
Yeah.
Good job, Sean.
Good job.
This is a hazy version.
me to Phil at the high school for recording arts, got introduced to TC, got introduced to Mama Shy, Ty Barnes, and the rest is history. They brought me in, and here we are now, 2 years later, got the next Move album coming out. Just want to let everybody out there know, if you have a dream, if you have goals, if you have a vision, stick to that vision, regardless of the conditions, regardless of anything, stick to that vision, because those dreams, those images in your mind, those things that you dream about, that you speak about to yourself, that you write about to yourself, that can actually become a reality. Each and every one of you are here for a reason. Each and every one of you have a legacy that you gotta deliver to the world. That's what you're here for, you know? And I'm glad that I found my reason, and I'm living it right now. It's called living a full life. And I just thank the Lord for it. It's an excellent thing, you know? And we have excellent students, excellent youth. They are the future. They're the future. And it's up to us as adults to be there for them. Regardless of how they act, we can't give up on them. Because all it takes is one thing to say. Out of 100 things, you say one thing that sparks something, and that can spark them to become the next president, the next great entrepreneurs. It's very serious to me, y'all. So, that's the story. So.
She loves me and I love her. Monogamy, there is no other. Yeah, yeah. The day we first met's like a best-selling story.
Sweet Dubai day.
Never again will I ever be lonely.